Let us start with the understanding of autoimmune diseases and the management through Ayurveda. We very well know nowadays the topic immunity is getting wide popularity because of the COVID scenario. And there are certain diseases which will be caused by the hyperactive stage of the immune system. So we will discuss how Ayurveda can visualize the pathogenesis of an autoimmune disease with some example, and how Ayurveda can go to the management level of autoimmune disease. Okay. We can see the picture. He is obedient. We are looking at the picture of a dog who is very much obedient. And you know, he is very much grateful to the host where he is staying. But sometimes you can see he will become very much aggressive, and he will come out of the house and he will be having all the problems. So the same thing is happening in the immune related conditions of autoimmunity. The immune system, which is basically protecting the human body, will turn against the natural host cell, and they will be destroying the body's own tissue. So we call it as autoimmune disease. So let us go to the example of SLE. In the picture, you are seeing a beautiful pencil picture where you can see the butterfly rashes are beautifully picturized using the pencil sketch. And this typical butterfly rash indicates that the patient is having systemic lupus erythematosus, that is SLE, systemic lupus erythematosus. And it is a multi-system involving autoimmune disease. I repeat, it is a multi-system involving autoimmune disease where multiple tissues are targeted by the immune system and they will be destroyed after a serious process of inflammation. So that is what is occurring in autoimmune disease. We can see in the next slide, systemic lupus erythematosus is a rheumatic disease characterized by autoantibodies directed against self-antigens, immune complex formation and immune dysregulation resulting in damage to essentially any organ. That is the point, any organ including the kidney, skin, blood vessels and nervous system. So you can see almost all the dhadus as per Ayurveda are affected by this hyperactive immune system. So I will tell you, Agni is very much parallel with Bala. Agni moolam balam pumsam. Agni moolam balam pumsam. And the same Bala is related with our immunity. So whenever there is a hyper functioning of Agni, Agni itself will destroy the normal dhadus and dhadu components. So you will be getting organ damages due to hyperactive Agni. We can even call the terminology Tishna Agni. So my point is there, in autoimmune disease, there will be a secondary stage . So it's a chronic autoimmune connective tissue disease that can affect any part of the body. All the three roga margas are affected in SLE. I am telling an example with the autoimmune disease SLE. All the three roga margas are affected. Kindly go to the next slide when I type. Okay. Don't go without telling the next slide. Please come back. As occurs in other autoimmune diseases, the immune system attacks the body cells, tissue, resulting in inflammation and tissue damage. This is what is happening. So I will be telling you, there will be a secondary episode of Dhadugada Atyagni, which will be leading to autoimmune disease. Okay, how autoimmune disease are mentioned in Ayurveda, how you can discuss it? We can see the impairment of Agni at specific level with a specific impact. A different Dhatuagnis are involved. Dhadus or related srodasas may suffer. This is what is happening. So you will be getting the hyperactive Agni at different level. Koshtagni, Dhatuagni, Bhudagni, but Dhatuagnis are more affected in autoimmune disease. Dhatuagnis related with the different dhadus and their concerned srodasas will be affected by autoimmune disease in the secondary stage. That is what I am telling. And then we have to think about a terminology mentioned in Ayurveda called Dhadupaga. Next slide, Dhadupaga. When Agni turns against normal dhadu, destruction of dhadus occur and dhadu or dhadu avayava may be the targets. Dhadu or dhadu avayava. What do you mean by dhadu avayava? The RBC, WBC, platelets, etc. are the dhadu avayava. You know, in a typical SLE, there will be anemia due to hemolysis. there will be leukopenia and there will be thrombocytopenia. So what I am telling is all the three compartments of the blood, RBC, WBC, platelets are undergoing paga and there will be reduction. So dhatu paga is a very important concept which is occurring in the autoimmune disease in the second episode of pathogenesis. So please think that dhatu paga is a destructive negative event. I repeat, dhatu paga is a destructive negative event when the basic dhatu saras are very seriously affected. Now, dhatu sara is giving strength to the body. So when there is a reduction in the dhatu sara, there will be all pathologies and there will be multiple paga. Paga is coming under inflammation. So when there is paga, different dhatus or dhatu components will be destroyed, and this is what is called dhatu paga. So that is very much important. Then let us ask the question, next slide. Why Agni turns against the dhatu? What is the reason by which the normally functioning Agni is turning against the dhatu? In normal health, there is a coordinated hormonal control over Agni. Even though Agni is a Taijasa Bhava, Agni is a Paitiga Bhava with Ushna Tishna Gunas, it is always controlled and regulated by other doshas also. So I would like to tell you that the Agni is controlled by Pitta. Agni is controlled by Kapha and Vata. Even though Agni itself is a Paitiga component, the other two doshas like Kapha and Vata are also influencing the Agni. Thereby, the Agni is maintained normal. And some other dhadus, malas and even ojas also control Agni. We very well know the enzymes, the hormones and all other neurotransmitters in the body together take part in the tissue level events in the body associated with the metabolism. So this entire dhatu paga where dhatu agni is performing, it is a coordinated, edited, regulated phenomenon. When there is a problem in this continuous, managed, regulated phenomenon occurs, then the agni will lose its normal control and it will become tikshna agni. Then it will destroy different dhatu components. This is what is occurring in the second stage of autoimmune disease, that is called dhatu paga. So my point is, remember the event dhatu paga in most of the autoimmune disease in the secondary stage and even tertiary stage. So initially there will be a dhatu mala sanchaya due to the so-called virudha hara. The virudha haras are playing a vital role. So there will be initial, then it will go to the pitta dominant dhatu paga, and finally it will go to a vata dominant dhatu kshaya. In autoimmune diseases, this control is lost at different domain. So what happens? Agni will go beyond control. Agni will lose its santulana. The samagni, the very first word in the definition of swastha is samagni. This samagni will become tikshnagni, and then tikshnagni will do the dhatu paka. And that is what is exactly happening in the advanced stages of autoimmune disease. Next slide. Now let us remember what are the features of dhatu paka. I told you there is an event beautifully picturized by Bhava Prakasha, is basically related with Bhaishajya Kalpana and other Drivya. But there are certain contributory areas to the so-called Nidana or Nidana Samprapti. The one area is dhatu paka concept. You know what is dhatu paka concept mentioned in Bhava Prakasha? It is clearly mentioned Nidra Nasa Hridistamba Vishtamba Gaurava Aruji Aradur Belaha Nischa Dhadunam Pakalakshanam. I will repeat once again. Nidra Nasa Hridistamba Vishtamba Gaurava Aruji Aradur Belaha Nischa Dhadunam Pakalakshanam. So when dhadus are destroyed by the dhadugada Atyagini, there will be Nidra Nasa Hridistamba Vishtamba Gaurava Aruji Aradi Belahani. We can see the nervous system, the cardiovascular system, the GIT, even when it comes to the arati, the psychological domain, and finally belahani. Again, the belahani indicates immunodepletion. So when dhatu sara is destroyed by dhatu paka, you know, sara itself is the ojas. Ojas tejas tu dhatu nam shuklam dhanam parasmrudam. So belahani will be there. So my concept is very simple. A normally functioning agni with initial mandha kapaguna anubandha will go to a hyperactive stage with continued vidyudahara samprat etc. Then agni will be losing its natural control, leading to excessive digestion of the normal tissue, resulting in dhadubhaga, and dhadubhaga will cause multiple inflammation in different sites, and finally you are getting dhadushaya. Dhadushaya means balakshaya. So when you are dealing an autoimmune disease, you have to face three stages: the initial stage of kapha mala sanchaya, then the madhyama stage, that is the very chronic and very dominant stage where there is pitta dominant paga, and finally dhadushaya, where there is vada domination with ojakshaya and balahani. So this is what we have to understand in a typical autoimmune disease. Next slide. Then coming to the clinical effect of dhadubhaga, in the previous slide already I explained. In the primary phase, you can see overactivity of agni bhava, destruction of dhadu fractions, dhadushaya, ojakshaya, then vada prakopa. And once vada prakopa is occurring, this pragupita vada will lead to secondary level vitiation at the further dhadus. So there are two events: the vada prakopa due to a dhadushaya, which is following the dhadupaka, then what happens, vada will become dominant, and then the dominant vada will naturally get the feedback support from multiple nidana, and this vitiated vada kopa will do further sthana samsraya in new sites. Then you will be getting the extension of samprati. That is why vasculitis, arthritis, dermatitis, hepatitis, and almost all the internal organs are affected in a typical multi-system autoimmune disease like SLE. You know, SLE is a typical model where you are getting multi-system. More than 2-3 srodasas are involved in SLE, and in every srodas you are getting the so-called arthritis, hepatitis, dermatitis, vasculitis. So everywhere, in nephritis. So multiple koshtangas as well as koshtanga related components are undergoing paka in advanced stages of autoimmune disease. I think the point is very clear. Multiple site dhadu paka is the clear feature in advanced stages of autoimmune disease. That is why we have to treat with the typical dhadu paka hara chikitsa in autoimmune disease. Then other factors to be considered here: satmya turns asatmya. That is another important point. The normal satmya will become asatmya. Why? Agni itself was doing very much natural friendly actions with the body. So this so-called agni is becoming asatmya. Satmya agni will do ahara paka. You know, I repeat, satmya agni will do ahara paka. Asatmya agni will do dhadu paka. There is a beautiful concept in grahani chikilsa, both by Vagbanda and Charaga. This is very much important at this point. I would recite that particular shastra bhaga from grahani chikilsa. Ahara magni pajadi dosha ahara varjide dhadun chineshu dosheshu jividam dhadu samkshaye. A very simple poem with a very 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 deep meaning. What is the sloga? Once again, I will tell you. Ahara magni pachati. In normal stage, agni will be doing the ahara pachana. We know that is physiology. Agni will do ahara pachana. Then dosha na ahara varjide. When there is no dosha, when there is no ahara, dosha. Dosha means ama dosha. Then the agni will do the ama dosha pachana. That is the part of treatment. First stage is agni will do ahara pajana, physiology. Second stage, the same agni will do dosha pajana, that means ama pajana, that is in the chikilsa. And finally, dosha nahara vardide dhadun shineshu doshoshu. Once the doshas are coming further shaya, here the dosha is mainly kapha and the other opposite vada, because opposite pitta, kapha vada, both are shida. When doshas are not able to control the agni, dhadun chineshu dosheshu jividam dhadu samshaye, then the agni will destroy dhadu, and this dhadu bhaga will be leading to dhadushaya. I think it is clear now. I will be telling it in a 4-level step. First stage is ahara pajana by agni, physiology. Second stage is dosha pajana or ama pajana by agni in chikilsa. Third is when doshas are further digested beyond a particular control, then dhadus will be destroyed. That is dhadu bhaga, the pathological stage. And once dhadu bhaga is prolonged, it will lead to dhadushaya and marana. That is the simple stage. So dhadu mala sanjayam, kapha domination, dhadu bhagam, pitta domination, and dhadu chayam, vata domination are the three clear cut stages in the nidana samprapti of a typical autoimmune disease. The middle stage is more important because it is inflammation dominant with the paga. So the dhadu paga stage is more important. But before you are getting dhadu mala sanjayam in multiple srodasas, and after you are getting dhadu shayam in multiple dhadus. That is the simple logic. Then viruddha concept within the body. We very well know what is viruddha. Nowadays we always talk much about the viruddhahara. So here what is happening? The body itself is becoming viruddha to the agni. So the agni is considering that body is not the friend. So viruddha concept is not coming from outside, inside the body. The agni find a viruddha stage with the related dhadu. The dhatugni and the related dhadus will mutually see as viruddha bhava. That is the point. Dhatugni and related dhadu will be considering each other as viruddha bhava, destroying the dhadu. That is dhadu bhaga. Then agni dushti by viruddha. Viruddhahara seva is a very dominant nidana in autoimmune disease along with other etiopathogenesis. Then agni, bela, ojas axis gets impaired. Agni, bela, ojas axis gets impaired. Agni is a paitiga bhava. Velam is the natural defense of the body. Sakajam, kalajam, yuktijam. And ojas is a kapaja bhava. See, velam is attributed to agni. Velam is attributed to ojas. But agni is a paitiga component and ojas is a kapaja component. We very well know. But both are agni. Why? Because the Ushna Rupa, Agneya Rupa factors are also responsible for Vela. The Saumya Rupa, Kapha components are also necessary in Vela. That is why Agni Moolam Velam Pumsam and Prakrutastu Velam Sleshma. So Velam is Ojas, Velam is Agni. One is Pitta related, other is Kapha related. But hyperactive Agni will even destroy Ojas cells. That is why dhadu paka will lead to dhadu chaya. Very important point. In our daily clinical practice, we will think about only the dhadu chaya stage only when there is a degeneration. But just remember, just before the dhadu chaya stage of degeneration, you are getting a dhadu paka stage where pitta is dominant. In dhadu paka only, you have to do the best treatment by gridapana, pittasya sarpishapanam. So sarpishpana or gridapana is very much important in the dhadu bhaga stage. Otherwise, the dhadu bhaga will very fastly develop or jump into dhadushaya. So the real responsibility of the classical physician is to treat the dhadu bhaga stage with all possible medicines, preferably with the gridha-related pittashamana drugs. Then you can delay or even you can avoid the dhadushaya. Once dhadushaya is reached, it will be vada domination with more kritsra sadhyata. So my point is very simple. The exact management efforts of autoimmune diseases should be done in the middle dhadu bhaga stage with grita kalpana. Then finally leading to ojas and immunity related disease. Next slide. In a multi-system disorder, koshta shakha relation is more important. You can see in typical autoimmune diseases like SLE, we can see multiple koshtangas are affected. Koshtangas means you are getting the involvement of liver, you are getting the involvement of the kidney, and even there are the involvement of shakha. Shakha means shakha rektadaya stoksha. Shakha rektadaya stoksha, the vascular system is affected. You very well know the butterfly rash appearing in the face, the malar rash, and even the other spots developing in the body with the vasculitis, inflammation of the blood vessels, all tell that shakha is also affected. Here the word shakha doesn't mean the upper limb, lower limb. It is the dhadu. Shakha, rektadaya, toksha. So from koshta to shakha, the shakhagati of the dosha is very much dominant in this pathology. That is very much important. Then identification of vikalpa samprapti is important. In every autoimmune disease, the involved dosha involvement will be different. दोषाणाम समवेदानाम विकल्पो अंश अंश कल्पना दोषाणाम समवेदानाम विकल्पो अंशांश कल्पना सो इन हाइपोथायरॉयडिज्म देयर विल बी अ डिफरेंट अंशांश कल्पना इन रूमेटॉइड आर्थराइटिस देयर विल बी अ डिफरेंट अंशांश कल्पना इन एसएलई इन डिफरेंट स्टेजेस ऑफ एसएलई यू आर गेटिंग डिफरेंट अंशांश कल्पना माय पॉइंट इज वेरी सिंपल द मैथमेटिकल क्वांटिफिकेशन ऑफ इन्वॉल्वड दोषास इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट इन विकल्प संप्राप्ति सो दैट इज टू बी ऑलवेज चेक्ड and most of the autoimmune diseases when they become chronic and advanced will be sannipada but sannipada again pittadika sannipadam that is the main stage you have to keep in your mind agni ojo axis starting from a problem to agni and ending with a problem to the ojas that is the full length course of a typical autoimmune samprati agni to ojas I think enough I have talked about the a samprapti of autoimmune disease in a 1 hour presentation then now I will go to the areas where we can search for management sannipada jwara chikitsa is very important sanni next slide sannipada jwara chikitsa is very much important sannipada jwara chikitsa deals with the different dhatu level management when it is seated at rakta level when it is mamsa level majja level medho level that is important antarvidradhi chikitsa The word under vidradi is nothing other than internal inflammation in multiple koshtanga internal organs hepatitis nephritis everything comes under vidradi only you know the multiple sites of under vidradi nabhi vasti yagat pleha ploma hrid kutchi vamshane syat vrikkayor apanecha then vadarakta kushta chikitsa because skin is affected vascular problems are there you know that conditions like Burgess disease or conditions like TAVO again you are getting the samprapti of rektavrata vada so rektavrata vada is mentioned under vadarakta never consider vadarakta is equivalent to gout pittadika vadarakta may be similar to gout but shakhagata vadarakta where rakta is obstructed by vada is naturally coming under the vadarakta only rakta margam nihandyasu shakha sandishu maruta nivish അന്യോന്യമാവാര്യ വേദനാപ്രഹരത്യസൂൻ സോ മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി വാസ്കുലൈറ്റിസ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് ടിപ്പിക്കൽ ഓട്ടോഇമ്മ്യൂൺ ഡിസീസസ് ആർ ഡ്യൂ ടു രക്താമൃത ബാധ കണ്ടെക്സ്റ്റ് ഓൺലി ആൻഡ് രക്തദുഷ്ടി ഈസ് ആൾവൈസ് ദെയർ ഇൻ കുഷ്ഠ ചികിത്സ സോ യു ക്യാൻ സെർച്ച് അഗൈൻ ഇൻ വാദരക്ത ചികിത്സ ആൻഡ് കുഷ്ഠ ചികിത്സ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് എ വി ടേക്ക് മെഡിസിൻസ് ലൈക്ക് ത്രിഫല ഗുഗ്ഗുലു മഞ്ജിഷ്ടാദി കഷായം കോകിലാക്ഷ കഷായം തിക്തക കഷായം ഫ്രം ദ വാദരക്ത കുഷ്ഠ പ്രകരണ ടു ട്രീറ്റ് മോസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് ദി കണ്ടീഷൻസ് ഓഫ് ദി വാദരക്ത Tiktaka kashayam is a very important drug we are giving in multiple inflammation associated with SLE because tiktaka rasas are the best pitta shamana and agni controlling agni regulating so kushta chikitsa vadarakta chikitsa is important pandu chikitsa why pandu chikitsa because I told you in SLE like diseases you are getting anemia leukopenia thrombocytopenia so pandu chikitsa is also applicable I told you the main treatment in the dhatu paka stage is gṛtapāna dādimādi gṛtam you know dādimādi gṛtam is a yoga indicated in pandu and that is very much applicable in various hematological stages of SLE because gṛta itself is very important vāta pittottare gṛta that is important when a pathology reaches a stage of vāta pitta gṛta is the main treatment you know let us go to jwara I think now you can see sannipada jwara and pandu in the same slides let us go to jwara chikitsa kashaya pana pathyaner dashaha idi lenghide sarpur dadyal kafe mande vata pittottare jware so jwara when it becomes vata pitta paka avastha sarpis is indicated so think about dadimadi krita think about tiktaka krita think about pancha tiktaka krita and even you can think about kalyanaka krita in advanced cases of autoimmune disease with neurological involvement you know in typical SLE there are stages where there will be neurological involvement even with the psychiatric manifestation then you can think about kalyanaka krita because kalyanakam is indicated in a manasika roga prakarana so tiktaka krita from pandu sorry tiktaka krita from kushta dadimadi krita from pandu and kalyana gṛtam from unmada prakarana are equally important in the management of this particular dhatu bhaga and even you can see varanadi krita from andarvidradi In Andhra Vidyadhi Chikilsa, Varanadi Gridam is indicated. You very well know Varanadi Kahammedo Mandakinitam Nechadi Adhivadam Shirasulam Gulmam Cha Andasta Vidyadhi. So again, Grida is good against Paga, Grida is good against Pitta, and Varanadi Grida is good against Andhra Vidyadhi, where there are Andhra Vidyadhi, internal multiple inflammation. So these are the very, very important points. Next slide. Now let us discuss a common disease which is very much seen in your practice, which is autoimmune. An autoimmune disease, rheumatoid arthritis, in which the joint linings becomes inflamed as part of the body's immune system activity. Rheumatoid arthritis is one of the most serious and disabling types of arthritis. Rheumatoid arthritis I am going to discuss now. Rheumatoid arthritis is a typical role model from the autoimmune spectrum. So we will discuss about rheumatoid arthritis to understand better the so-called autoimmune disease. We can see the normal picture and the abnormal picture in the next slide. We can see the bony erosions, cartilage loss, inflamed synovium and the swollen capsule. All these things we can see. The bony erosion. All the bony erosion, cartilage loss and inflamed synovium tell there is dhadu pakam. Asti dhadu pagam, majja dhadu pagam in the sandhi, that is the typical feature of bony erosion. And after the paga, there will be degeneration, shayam. So dhadu paga to dhadu shaya is the typical course in rheumatoid arthritis. Initially, there will be kapanibandham, dhadu malasanjayam with the swelling. Then dhadu pagam, erosion. And finally, dhadu shayam, degeneration, that is typical. Next slide, please. Criteria, everybody know, morning stiffness, arthritis of three or more joints, arthritis of the hand, rheumatoid nodules, rheumatoid factor, radiological changes, and symmetrical arthritis. These are the major criteria. Any four from the seven for minimum 6 weeks is mandatory to call it as a rheumatoid arthritis. Everybody know, just to give an appearance. Before we go to the treatment, I told you the diagnostic criteria of rheumatoid arthritis. You can see all the joints are affected. Hasta, pada, shiro, gulpa, trika, jan, uru, sandish. Every bilateral symmetry is there in the rheumatoid arthritis. Okay, this is next slide. Next. You can see all the bilateral joints are affected in rheumatoid arthritis. And this is acute RA. You can see the interphalangeal joints are very much swollen. It is clearly mentioned that Thamanni anguli sandhinam sangoja anga griho atiruk. Thamanni anguli sandhinam sangoja anga griho atiruk. It is mentioned in Vata dominant Vata recta. Anguli sandhis are mentioned only in this context in Ayurveda. Thamanni anguli. The word thamani indicates blood vessel. The word anguli sandhi indicates intraphalangeal joint. Both are coming in a single situation in the classical Ayurveda, that is called Vata adhika Vata rectam. Thamanyanguli sandhinam sangojanga griho atiruk. Atiruk, morning stiffness will be there. And you can see the next slide, chronic RA, you can see it will be all deviation. So acute RA will be having all swelling. Now you can see the acute RA swelling, kapha domination, and the chronic RA degeneration, wasting, ulna deviation, muscular atrophy, shosha, swan neck deformity. So everything is leading to vata. So from the first kapha sanchaya to the middle stage of paga pitta, and finally dislocation, degeneration and mamsa shosha, that is chronic RA. Again, next slide, you can see some of the pictures. Advanced RA, swan neck deformities and synovial thickening of wrist. Advanced RA, swan neck deformities and synovial thickening of wrist. You can see totally the joint will become degraded and destroyed. And you can see this is what is happening in the advanced Gambhira stages of Vata dominant Vata recta. Pitta dominant Vata recta can be gout, but I think the Vata dominant Vata recta mimics so many pathologies of rheumatoid arthritis, including the joint deformity. You can see the joint deformities are mentioned detail in Gambhira Vata recta only. Clearly mentioned Pindaniva Jaratyandar Vakri Kurvamscha Vegavan. The joints are getting Vakri Kurvadi, the bending of the joint. Let us think about the ulnar deviation. In no Amavada, in no Santigada Vada, you are getting the deformities. deformities are mentioned only in one joint disease in Ayurveda, that is Gambhira Vata Rakta. I believe Gambhira Vataadika Vata Rakta is very much similar to chronic RA. Pittaadika Vata Rakta may be similar to gout because there will be daha, raga, paga, sopha, everything. But Vataadika Vata Rakta, when it reaches the Gambhira, will be exactly like this picture with all deformity and mamsakshaya. Next slide. Next slide, again you can see there will be deformities, same deformities are occurring in the leg also. You can see the lower limb is also the lateral deviation of the toe. Padayor mulam astaya kadajit hastayorabhi is applicable to this also. Next. Next. Investigations, everybody know acute phase reactants like ESR and CRP. Actually, a rise in ESR and C-reactive protein, CRP, are telling that there is Dhatupaka. So the real laboratory evidence for Dhatupaka is raised ESR and CRP. Then RA factor is again identified, ACCP. And finally, you can visualize the interior of the destroyed joint by arthroscopy. And of course, you can go for all the imageology, starting from the X-ray to CT and other advanced imageological studies. So all these investigations will tell you what is the gravity, what is the depth of Dhatupaka in your patient. I am repeating the word, what is the depth of Dhatupaka in the asthi, majja, and even in the related vascular and dermatological component, that is the next purpose of doing all these investigations. Now you can see the normal and abnormal X-ray. Next slide. This is the first one, is the normal hand. Here you can see the joint spaces are very much reduced. Bone erosion can be seen. Rheumatoid arthritis, the bone erosion and bone displacement. This is very much mimicking the picture. So bone degeneration followed by Dhatupaka, like that, which is following the Dhatupaka. And finally, this is the next slide. So this is the next picture where the ultimate Dhatu Shaya with deformity. This is what is the sloga mentioned under Bhindanyipa Charatyandar Vakri Gurvamsya Vegavan Karodi Kancham Pangumba Sharire Sarvadas Charan. Karodi Kancham Pangumba. Even there can be limbing if it affects the hip joint and the knee joint. So all the possibilities of deformities are there in advanced RA. Which is nothing other than Dhatupaka leading to Dhatushaya. Dhatupaka leading to Dhatushaya. That is why when we are getting a patient with rheumatoid arthritis, after initial amapajana and kapashamana, sopashamana drugs, we will go to a very good agni deepti chikilsa. And once the jadragni is found to be increased and normal, the very important treatment is Gridapana. The very important treatment is Gridapana only. Now coming to the management principle, clinical conditions decides the treatment. Clinical condition decides the treatment. We cannot tell that during the entire course of an autoimmune disease, the treatment principle is same. That is not correct as per my belief. I strongly believe that the different stages, we can call it as Vyadhi Avastha. The different Vyadhi Avastha or clinical stages will tell you what is the real medicine. So that is to be done like that only. And Samprapti key stages, different dhadus and srodhasas, you have to assess Dhatupaka, the gravity, the level, the degree, you have to assess Sara Hani. Sara means the Ashta Sara. Sarastu, the Bela content of the each tissue. That is why Sara Hani of different dhadu. Then Anyonya Dushti, whether Vata is vitiated by Avarana, and then vitiated Vata is vitiating other dhadus. That is what is called Anyonya Dushti. Then Asatmida to Sharira, how the body's own Bela, body's own Agni fraction, body's own Ojo component is turning against the body. That is Asatmida to the Sharira, Virudha. And finally, Rogolpatti. Rogolpatti may manifest with a particular Koshtanga. Sometimes may manifest as hepatitis. Sometimes may manifest as glomerulonephritis. Sometimes may manifest as carditis in the valves. Sometimes may manifest as joints, arthritis, sometimes skin, dermatitis, sometimes the blood vessels, vasculitis. So every dhadu component will be affected. So go to the treatment principle as per the involved dhadu and srodhas. If you are getting dermatological features due to an autoimmune disease, go to Kushta Chikilsa Vihara Vardhana. If you are autoimmune disease, go to Pandu Chikilsa with Rekta Sara Vardhana. If you are getting a pathology of arthritis with autoimmune disease, go to Vata Rekta or Santigata Vata Chikilsa increasing Astisara. Astisara Vardhana. This is what I am telling. The stage, the clinical phase, the Vyadhi Avastha determines the exact practical treatment in a multi-system affecting autoimmune disease. I think it is clear. Now coming to the management protocol for RA. Now we will discuss rheumatoid arthritis as an example, because a very common autoimmune disease, we need external treatment and local treatment. We need even systemic treatment. So external and pradeshika chikilsa, the local treatments will do the vyadhi shamana in the particular area. Sandhi shobha can be treated by a lepana. Sandhi shula can be treated by a dhara. But you need an autoimmune correction. That can be done only by well-designed panchakarma followed by rasayana. Because most of the autoimmune diseases are very much notorious for their relapse and remission. Just like the punaravartagajara concept, they will be having a relapse and a remission. So you have to always think about the rasayana chikilsa. If you read Vadarakta Nidana, you can see a line in the last area of Nidana Samprati. Bhutva bhutva pranashyandi muhurabhur bhavanticha. Bhutva bhutva pranashyandi muhurabhur bhavanticha. So it can subside and it will gain the gravity from the external aggravating factors. Then it will again become more and more dangerous. So that is why you need rasayana chikilsa to prevent the recurrence. In acute RA, follow uttana vadarakta treatment. I am telling you, you have to do amapachana internally. But externally, some treatments are there which are very much similar from vata dominant vadarakta. Lebana, abhyanga, parishega, avagaha, var upanaha. So this is the order. Start from lebana, then go to abhyanga, then go to parishega, and then go to avagaha, urupanaha. So always start the treatment with a sandhigatha lenghana. Sandhigatha lenghana is lepana. In a koshtagatha vyadi, the lenghana is upavasa. In a sandhigatha vyadi, lenghana means lepana, which are done by root shavashada, because swelling, shobha is always there due to kapha nubandha, ama nubandha. Kapha, ama, both are snigda, shida, guru. So do the opposite of Rutsha, which is Ushna, so apply Lepana. Once the Sobha is treated, then goes to the Abhyanga when there is Vata. And then you can go to the Parishega with Chira Dhara, Kashaya Dhara, Taila Dhara, Mahasneha Dhara, depending upon the stages. And when there is a lumbosacral condition, you can go for Avagaha Sveda. And even with a monoarthritis dominantly seen, you can select Upanaha Sveda. So this is the order. Start from Lepana, then go systematically up and up like that. Then clinical tips for your practice. Pain dominant joint is Vata. Tenderness and swelling is mainly Pitta. And swelling and stiffness is mainly Kapha. Painful joint Vata. Pain and tenderness Vata Pitta. Tenderness and swelling Pitta Kapha. And swelling and stiffness, it is kapha predominant. This is very, very, very important. So my dear friends, next time when you see your patient in your clinic, assess the dosha vigalpa by the above symptomatic analysis. Pain, tenderness, swelling, and even numbness, supti. Supti is always a kapha bhava. Then assess which is vada, which is pitta, which is kapha, and then go to the concerned lepana like that. Now I will tell example. Lepana, external application of medicated paste, Nagaradi Lepa, if it is Vata dominant and traumatic background, Grihadhumadi Lepa, if there is Vata Kapha, Jadamayadi Lepa, if there is Pitta domination, Yellum Nishadi Lepa, it's a Malayalam yoga, Yellum Nisha, Yellum means Tila, Nisha means our Haridra, so that is again Kapashamana, Kottam Chukadi Lepa, Kapashamana, Kottam means Kushta. Chukku means Nagara. So Kottam Chukadi is a Tishna yoga which is indicated in Kapaja Shobha. A fluctuating swelling is Vata. സ്പർശാക്ഷമത്വം ടെൻഡർനെസ് സ്വെല്ലിംഗ് ഇസ് പിത്ത എ സ്തൈമിത്യ സ്തിമിത ശീത ശോഫ എ കോൾഡ് വെട്ടി സ്റ്റിഫിനസ് സ്വെല്ലിംഗ് ഇസ് കഫജ ദെൻ വാദിക മീൻസ് നാഗരാതി ലേപ വാത കഫ മീൻസ് ഗൃഹധൂമാതി പൈത്തിക മീൻസ് ജഡാമയാദി കഫജ മീൻസ് സെല്ലു നിഷാദി ആൻഡ് കൊട്ടൻ ചുക്കാദി സോ ദിസ് ഈസ് ദ ലോജിക് ബിഹൈൻഡ് സെലക്ടിംഗ് ദ ലേപന ഇൻ ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് സ്റ്റേജസ് ഓഫ് എ ടിപ്പിക്കൽ ആർത്രൈറ്റിസ് വെയർ ദർ വിൽ ബി സ്വെല്ലിംഗ് ഡ്യൂ ടു കഫ സ്വെല്ലിംഗ് കഫ ട്രീറ്റ്മെന്റ് ഈസ് രൂക്ഷ that is done by lepana swelling is kapaja caused by snigdha treatment is rudra done by lepana so that is the point next slide then I told you after lepana you can go to the abhyanga uttanam lepana abhyanga parishega avagahane is the sutra expected outcome is the reduction in joint pain in lepana the outcome expected was joint swelling in തൈലധാരാവി എക്സ്പെക്ട് ജോയിന്റ് പെയിൻ റിഡക്ഷൻ ധന്വന്തരം തൈലം വാദാധികം കേതകി മൂലാദി തൈലം സന്ധിഗത വാദം വിത്ത് ഡീജനറേഷൻ നാരായണ തൈലം വെല്യം പിണ്ട തൈലം പൈത്തികം ആരനാളാദി തൈലം പൈത്തികം ക്ഷീരബലാ തൈലം വാദപൈത്തികം കൊട്ടം ചുക്കാദി തൈലം ആൻഡ് കാർപ്പാസാസ്ത്യാദി തൈലം വാദ കഫശമനം ഓർ കഫാഡോമിനന്റ് കഫശമനം സോ ദീസ് ആർ ദ അംശാംശ കൽപ്പന ഓഫ് ഡിഫറെന്റ് ഓയിൽസ് നെക്സ്റ്റ് സ്ലൈഡ് ദെൻ യു ക്യാൻ ഗോ ടു പരിഷേക ദശമൂല സ്ത്രുത ക്ഷീര യു ക്യാൻ ബോയിൽ ദ ദശമൂല വിത്ത് മിൽക്ക് ബോയിൽ ദശമൂല വിത്ത് മിൽക്ക് ആൻഡ് ഡു ആസ് എ ധാര ഇൻ ദ അഫക്റ്റഡ് ജോയിന്റ് ദശമൂല സ്ത്രുത ക്ഷീരം സദ്യശൂല നിവാരണം ദറ്റ് ഈസ് ദ ക്ലാസിക്കൽ റെഫറൻസ് ദശമൂല സ്ത്രുത ക്ഷീരം ദശമൂല സ്ത്രുത ക്ഷീരം സദ്യശൂല നിവാരണം ധാന്യാമ്ലധാര യു ക്യാൻ പ്രിപ്പയർ ദ മെഡിക്കേറ്റഡ് കാഞ്ചിക ദറ്റ് ഈസ് ആൽസോ ഗുഡ് ആൻഡ് ഈവൻ ധാര വിത്ത് മഹാസ്നേഹ വെൻ ദർ ഈസ് ക്രോണിക് അഡ്വാൻസ്ഡ് വാദപ്രകോപ വിത്ത് മാംസക്ഷയ യു ക്യാൻ സീ ദ മസിൽ വേസ്റ്റിംഗ് അസോസിയേറ്റഡ് വിത്ത് അഡ്വാൻസ്ഡ് ആർ എ ദെൻ യു ക്യാൻ തിങ്ക് അബൌട്ട് ദ മാക്സിമം ബ്രഹ്മണ ബൈ ആൾ ഫോർ ഗൃത യു നോ സർപ്പുർ മജ്ജ വസ തൈലമീസ് ചതുഷ്പ്രകാര സ്നേഹ And when all the four together combined, it is called Mahasneha, and you can do Dhara with Mahasneha also. Then Upanaha, Upanaha expected, expected outcome is the reduction of joint swelling and stiffness, and Upanahas are preferred. You can see Upanahas are preferred in severe painful joints with restricted movements only. Next slide, please. One example of Upanaga Seda, I will tell you. In chronic swollen joints, please read it. In chronic swollen joints, you can see Upanaga with Nagaradi Lepa Churna, Saindhava, Dhanyamla and Narayana Thaila. In any Upanaga, you need one Churna, Vadahara Churna, സൈന്ധവ ലവണ ധാന്യാമ്ല അമ്ലദ്രവ്യ ആൻഡ് വൺ തൈല സോ നാരായണ തൈല സോ ദീസ് ഫോർ തിങ്സ് ഷുഡ് ബി മിക്സ്ഡ് ടുഗദർ ഹീറ്റഡ് ആൻഡ് ദെൻ ഇറ്റ് ക്യാൻ ബി യൂസ്ഡ് ഫോർ ദി ധാന്യാമ്ല ധാര ഓൺലി സോ ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് വാട്ട് വി ആർ ടെല്ലിംഗ് നെക്സ്റ്റ് സ്ലൈഡ് ദെൻ അനദർ യോഗ ഈസ് കൊട്ടം ചുക്കാദി ലേപ ചൂർണ യു ക്യാൻ യൂസ് ആൻഡ് ഈവൻ യു ക്യാൻ യൂസ് Saindhava and even you can use Karpasasthyadi Thailam and Dhanyamla vinegar. So these are the different examples of the so-called Upanaha Dravya. If there is stiffness, you use the Kottam Chukkadi. If there is more pain, you can use the Nagaradi Lepa. That is the logic. Next slide, please. Now we come to the internal medicine. Rasna Rendadi Kashaya. But before going to the specific Vyadishamana Kashaya, you can start with Amrudottaram Kashaya. I am telling you, Kashayas which are Amapadana can be done. Amrudottaram Kashayam. Then you can go to the Vyadishamana medicines like Rasnerandadi Kashayam, Guggula Diktaka Kashayam, Manjishtadi Kashayam, Ashtavarga Kashaya, Kaishura Guggulu, Chandra Prapa Guguliga, etc. These are the different medicines which can be given according to the condition. But internal medicine start with ama pachana agni deepana medicine. So in my practice we will start with the so called amrudottaram kashayam and the so called deepana medicines like, and even you can add medicines like vaishwanara churna to it. Next slide please. Now administration of guduji, that is very important. Guduji is a very good immunoregulator. So in my experience, guduji can be given in different format in most of the autoimmune conditions. So guduji vadarakte, the advanced drug guduji is given as guduji kashayam, guduji ghridam, and guduji can be given in different formulation to treat the different condition. Because if you take any medicine mentioned in amavata and vadarakta, which are coming under the joint spectrum, you will be always getting guduji. And in vascular lesions of autoimmune conditions also, guduchyadi kashayam is important. So guduji is a very dominant yoga, and guduji is having very good immunoregulatory action also. So guduji can be used in different methodologies to treat the autoimmune disease. Next slide. Then you can go for rheumatoid arthritis. Secondary stage, you have to go for the systemic treatment. I told you in the primary level, you have seen the behi parimarjana chikilsa, or you have seen the medicines which are given externally like lepana, abhyanga, etc. But now you can even see the medicines like panchakarma, rasayana. So the systemic or internal treatments are very much important. So secondary stage, the treatment is done by panchakarma and rasayana. First stage was external treatment, that was for symptom, and second treatment is for system. Next. Then panchakarmas in rheumatoid arthritis, you can do virechana, you can correct the vada by masti, pitta by virechana, and there will be some local rakta dushti which can be treated by rakta mosha. So virechana, vasti, rakta mosha, all the three are important. Next. Then the important vasti which we do in madhu tailika vasti, in which madhu and tailas are taken equally. Madhu and taila are taken equally. So madhu tailika vasti is very much important, and it is a rasayana vasti, and which is very good even against diabetes mellitus. So nowadays you are getting so many patients with lifestyle disorders and rheumatoid arthritis with multiple autoimmune condition. So madhu tailika vasti with erenda mulakoda misikalka can be given as a treatment. Next slide. Then you can even do the rakta moksha. I told you rug raga toda daheshu jalu kapur vinirhare, rug raga toda daheshu jalu kapur vinirhare. So jaluga can be done. Jaluga avacharana is very important. Don't directly jump into jaluga avacharana. First do sneha bana with tiktaka grada, something like that, because you need pitta shuddhi. Then you go to the virechana by abhibatti churna or proper erenda taila. Then you go to rakta shuddhi. So my point is very simple. Start with the sneha pana, then go to the virechana, then go to the rakta shuddhi. Virechana will do pitta shuddhi, and jaluga avacharana will do rakta shuddhi. You need both. So you cannot do the treatment both irregularly. Start with the sneha pana, then virechana, then preferably jaluga avacharana is the protocol against vasculitis as well as dermatitis, even arthritis. Three important stages of autoimmune disease: vasculitis, arthritis, and dermatitis. Jaluga avacharana is important. The slogan is very simple: rug raga toda daheshu jaluga apur vinirhareed, rug raga toda daheshu jaluga apur. And finally the rasayana, you have to do some rasayana chikilsa: vardhamana pippali rasayanam, chavana prasham, and bhalladaka rasayanam. Three important rasayana: vardhamana pippali rasayanam, chavana prasham, bhalladaka rasayanam. Vardhamana pippali is indicated in a condition where there is again kapha vada domination. Chavana prasha, bhalladaka, bhalladaka rasayanam is more indicated in kapha dominant frozen condition, because bhalladaka is good against kapha. Kapajostina rogostina vibandosti yaschana yamna bhalladakam hanyat shikram agni velapradam. So that is what is bhalladaka. the cyanide. Now coming to the conclusion, rheumatoid arthritis success area, Ayurvedic treatments are not mere analgesics. That is the point. You are not giving a kashaya only to treat the local pain. You are going to correct the internal vascular issue, autoimmune issue. So you have to give a little bit long time treatment, but those treatments will be making some creative and constructive changes in the progression of the disease. So they will be bringing a permanent relief to the underlying samprapti. They are not for a symptom, they are for the underlying samprapti. They prevent further progression and deformities. The further progression as well as the deformities can be minimized if you intervene at the dhatupaka stage. Then prevent the extra articular manifestations. We very well know rheumatoid arthritis will go to other structures also. The heart will be affected, the lungs will be affected, even the eyes will be affected. So multiple organs are affected by rheumatoid arthritis. Even though we tell it is an arthritis, multiple organs are affected, so that can be prevented by this treatment. Say for example, if you do virejana and rasayana in a middle stage of dhatupaka, the samprapti will not proceed further. Even though it proceeds further, it will be having minimum impact. It will be having minimum gravity. That is the periodical shodhana and the rasayana are important. It is clearly mentioned in our science, buddhi prasadam velamindriyanam dhadu sthiratam jalanasya dipti chiracha pagam vayasaha karodi samsodhanam samyak upasyamanam. Then prevent the extra articular manifestations. That is what I have already told you. Then delays the age-related degeneration. This is very important. The age-related degeneration, because autoimmune diseases, once they become in the advanced stage, naturally the dosha will be vata. And if the age is also vata, it will be very difficult. Then definitely you have to think about certain Brahmana yoga. Certain Brahmana yoga, Belya yoga, which can even prevent the Mamsa Shosha. In that context only, Vidaryadi Gridam is important. Vidaryadi Gridam is Vata Shamanam, Vata Pitta Shamanam, Shosha Shamanam. Vidaryadi Rayam Hridya Brahmano Vata Pittaha Shosha Gulma Anga Marda Urdha Shosha Kasa Harugana. My point is very simple. In advanced arthritis, when there is Mamsa Shosha due to disused joints, disused atrophy, you have to give something which is gridam, pitta shamanam, but that should be more belya brahmana and shosha shamana. That is why vidaryadi gridam. So vidaryadi gridam is indicated against the problems of what? The shosha. You have seen in the picture the mamsa shosha seen with the finger or the interosseous membrane or the interphalangeal joint. So in such condition, vidaryadi gridam. Another option is rasna dashamuladi gridam. Another option is Rasna Dashamuladi Gridam, Panchakasan, Sirakambam, Yoni Vamshana Vedanam, Sarvang, Eganga Rogamscha, Sapliha, Urdva, Anilanjaye. So Rasna Dashamuladi Gridam is another option. And even you can think about Induganta Gridam. Induganta Gridam is again very good against the immunity related condition. It is a Belya yoga. Induganta Gridam can be given. And another yoga is Shatpala Grida. So my point is coming towards the application of medical application of Grida Kalpana. Grida Kalpanas are very, very important in Astishaya, especially when it is prepared with Tiktarasa Drivya. Astishaya, Tiktarasa Drivya, Grida Kalpanas are very much important. So you can think about the Grida Kalpanas like Vidaryadi Grida, Shatpala Grida, Induganta Grida, and Rasna Dashamula Grida. And finally, improves immunity and good health. That is what I am telling. If you continuously take a painkiller or NSAID or even steroid, you are promoting the Dhadu Bhaga event and you are inviting the Dhadu Shaya. But our medicines, if given in the middle stage of Dhadu Bhaga, they can delay the degeneration and it will improve the quality of life also. Not only to the joint, the entire body will be getting the positive response of the Gridapana, and which is equal to the Rasayana Kalpana. So that is very much important. So improves immunity and good health. So now I am concluding. I think the time is coming up. Agni Moolam Velam Pumsam. In the initial slides, I told you Agni Moolam Velam Pumsam. Agni is the real reason for Velam. But the same Agni can
turn against you. The same Agni can turn against you, and then we call it as autoimmune disease. So Agni is a double-edged sword. Next slide. Agni is a double-edged sword, just like your immunity is a beware of the double-edged sword. So Mandagni, Tishnagni. Mandagni will also lead to disease due to Ama, and Tishnagni will also lead to disease, that is Dhadupaga. See the difference. This is the net conclusion. This is the net take-home message of this autoimmune disease presentation. Agni, which is depending on the Bela, that is Agni Moolam Belam Pumsa, immunity, and it is having double edges. Mandaguna Agni, Mandagni, Dhadumala Sanjayam, Kapaja Rogas, Tishnagni, Dhadubagam, Paithika Roga, and Vada in the middle will control both, being the Yoga Vahi. So when you explain immunity, autoimmunity, you are getting the best example of Pittam Pangu, Kapham Pangu, Pangavo Maladhadavaha, Vayuna, Yatra Niyandi, Tatra Gacchanti, Megavat. Kapha blessed by Vada, you are getting Srodo Rodha, Ama, Malasanjaya, Sobha. Vada combined with Pitta, you are getting Dhadubhaga, destruction, Shosha, and immunity decline. So Mandaguna initial stage, Tishnaguna last stage, and in between you are getting the entire screenplay, Sambrati of a autoimmune disease. So treat Mandaguna, Dhadumala Sanjaya with Divana Padana drugs in the first stage, empower the Agni to the normal quality, and then give every medicine when it becomes hyperactive. When it is becoming hyperactive with all raised ESR Dhadubhaga, go to the Gridabana, because Gridabana is best against Vata Pitta. Vata Pitta will lead to always Paga only. Mala Sanjayam Kapham, Pagam Pittam, Chayam Vadam. These are the three stages. All the three can be seen in a chronic autoimmune disease with specific targets of Dhadus and Sthana Samsraya points. So treat accordingly. So that is next slide. So this is what I have to tell. Autoimmune diseases represent a very wide area in Ayurveda. So treat accordingly with Amshamsha Kalpana. Three points are there. Assess the Vikalpa Samprapti, assess the status of Agni, and assess what are the srodasas involved. Then definitely you can apply internal treatment, external treatment, Vihiparimarjana Chikilsa, Panchakarma Chikilsa, Rasayana Chikilsa. With all the lifestyle modifications, you can give a very good results to many of the current commonly available autoimmune diseases. So I am very much thankful to the organizers, and I am very much thankful to the listeners for giving your time of attention. Thank you. Learn Ayurveda, love Ayurveda, live Ayurveda. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for the informative session, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you for the informative session, sir. We are overwhelmed with the responses from the participants. Here are a few questions which have been asked by our participant. So the first question from them is, when there is a strong family history of any disease condition, can it be avoided or prevented?
No, a very strong family history is a strong samprapti ghataka. We cannot avoid it, but we can prevent the gravity. If the somebody is getting the birth in a very family history, then they have to take all the so-called srodo viruddha, sorry, means srodo opposite aharas, vyadi pratyanika drugs. Say for example, if somebody is having a risk of developing arthritis due to the hereditary problem, then they can definitely take gridabana in the middle age itself. When they become 25, they can start some Gridabana, do periodical sodhana. That is the main thing. You can only delay the onset, you can only reduce the gravity, because the hereditary factors are very strong. Kulajja vyadis are very strong, but you can definitely minimize the gravity by adopting the treatment at the right time. That is why we tell Purve Vaisi Mathyeva Rasayana. Okay, next.
The next question. When to administer Rasayana in autoimmune condition, acute or chronic stage, or which stage?
I already am explained. No, in the acute stage, you need only the Vihiparimarjana Chikilsa. In the secondary stage, after Shodhana, you can do Rasayana. Already I discussed.
in case of RA with diabetes mellitus type 2?
See, in RA and diabetes mellitus, you have to think both. I told an example of a madhu tailika vasti. You go to the slide. Madhu tailika vasti is a very good panchakarma where rasayana as well as prameha shamana with sandhigad action. So vasti karmas which are rasayana and removing the insulin resistance are very good in arthritis. Next.
Are there immunosuppressant drugs available in Ayurveda?
Not audible.
Are there any immunosuppressant drugs available in Ayurveda? Like they were widely used in treatment of autoimmune disorders in contemporary medical sciences.
See, actually, we never recommend immunosuppressants in that context. We recommend immunoregulators. We recommend immunoregulators. That is why Guduji and Ashwagandha are important. Guduji is the best drug of immunoregulation. Not immunosuppressant or not immunomodulator. Immunoregulator, that is Guduji. So most of the Kalpanas are having Guduji.
Next question. How can treatment principles differ in acute and chronic stages of any...
And not audible, madam. Louder.
How can treatment principle differ in acute and chronic stages of any autoimmune conditions?
The person who asked the question didn't listen to the entire. I told that only. In the acute stage, you have to do the bahiparimardhana chikitsa, lepana abhyanga parishega avagaha, internal medicines with the kashayadi. And later stage, vidhe asthavana snehabana. So vidhejanam, asthavanam, snehabanam and the rectam mosha. So initial treatments are amapadana and srodo shuddhikara, and the later treatments are belya and dadu shekhara. I'll told all the things. Very detailed told.
How fast stage of kapha converts into pitta dominant stage?
What?
How does first stage of kapha convert into pitta dominant stage?
Madam, you make clear the first part of the question. You keep your mic closer. I am not getting the first part of your question.
Am I audible, sir?
Yes, you are audible, but not the first part always. First part of the question is missing. I am guessing first, only.
Okay. How first stage of kapha convert into pitta dominant stage?
What means kapha? What is the question?
How does first stage of kapha convert
what is
into
the first stage?
How does first stage of kapha convert into pitta dominant stage?
See, that is correct. How does that word, how does, was not audible. Okay. So how does means, you know, when the snigdha guna and guru guna of kapha, which binds the joints, is lost by paga ushna tishna, then the sandhishus, that slish alingani, the binding property will be lost. So the cartilages which are supporting the joint will be lost with the bone erosion. So kapha is slish alingani, binding the structures. It will be destroyed by ushna guna, tishna guna, paga, and then automatically there will be the erosion. So from the samhadi bhava, from the combined stage, you are going to the detached stage. Kapha means combining together, and pitta means paga separating. So that is the stage.
The next question is, how to differentiate between different types of Agni Dushti and Asatmya clinically?
No, Agni Dushti easily, no, Mandagni, Tishnagni, Vishamagni. Mandagni will be always leading to Dhadugada hypofunctioning. Dhadu hypofunctioning, Ushta level hypofunctioning is Mandagni. Every system will be having a slow momentum, slow velocity. And Tishnagni means it will be hyperactive. It will attack more. All the hypersensitivity conditions, all the allergic conditions, all the autoimmune serious conditions are hyperactivity, tikshnagni. Vishamagni will be always irregular. Irregular means we cannot make a stable stage. Sometimes mandagni, sometimes tikshnagni, like that it will be having a fluctuation. In Vadadiga Vadarakta, it is clearly mentioned, Dhamanyanguli Sandhinam Sangojanga Griho Adiruk. Next line. Shobhasya Ryaushya Krishnattam Shyavada Vriddhi Hanaya. Vriddhi Hani. The swelling will go up and down. This up and down nature is the Vada dominant stage. The Tishnata or the Ashugari or the acute or the Sparshakshamatva, that is Pitta stage, Tishnagini. And the Stimit, Stimitya, Stiffiness, Mandada, Sup, Shidada,
all are kapaja, mandagini. So mandagini hypofunctioning, dikshanagini hyperfunctioning, vadagini vishamagini irregular functioning.